In this video we will see how we can use raw data bound command and normal HTML to assign attribute to a new link button which is inside a grid view, and what is the difference between that. For example, there is a label over link button over here inside a template column, and inside that we are creating a link button, for example, just for the purpose of showing an alert for before deletion, for example. So we will create a link button which will say delete record, and on client click we are going to show a confirmation message, which is actually a JavaScript method to confirm before deletion. So delete, or we will say confirm delete. This is a JavaScript function which can be assigned from on client click. I want to show you the difference between assigning it with the help of on client click and or raw data bound. So for example, this is a script. Type is equal to JavaScript function return confirm are you sure to delete the record. So if we run this, it will show us the message of confirmation, which is actually inside JavaScript, but we are assigning it from HTML which is inside this grid view. We can achieve this same with on raw data bound, but what is difference between both? We will ask it to create a on-raw data bound command. If it is raw, the raw type is equal to raw type dot data raw. We will say e dot raw dot find control. There we, as an example, we will create one more link button to keep a difference. This is lnk delete 2, let's say, and delete record from raw data bound, just as an example, and to identify both as a separate. We will remove this one and we will assign the same thing from on raw data bound. So this is a link button. We will do typecasting and we will say dot attributes. And let's say if it is cell number 4, we will count from here 0, 1, 2, 3. This is third number cell, and we are going to assign an attribute which is a JavaScript function. So JavaScript function is this one, and we will assign it. On click, JavaScript colon. Now what is going to happen? The cell number is wrong actually, so we will see 0, 1, 2, 3. Link button to, it's a link button, and sorry, this one is a, I have written wrong, this is not a function name, it has to be a link button. So once it runs, you will see these both are present over here. Now both have same functionality, but what actually is better? If let's say in future if we remove any column name from here, it means the cell number is also changed. So if I run it now, it is not going to find the link button, which because we removed any column, which can happen with any software. So it means that if you want to avoid any error in this kind of situation, it is much better that we do not use the raw data bound in this situation, and it is much better to use any attribute with the help of on client click if we want to assign the client click functionality. If there is something else, there are certain other options. You can do one more thing to avoid this error. You can say GD departments, for example, this is the grid view name, dot sales columns dot count minus 1. So it means the last column, this can work as well. I will run this again. This will work as well. This can be dynamic, so even if you remove this, it is not going to affect if you are going to remove in future. But actually I would suggest that it is better to use from the HTML itself. So if you remove any columns, it is not going to affect anything.